New details have emerged Friday about former Vice President Joe Biden's heartbreaking final moments at the bedside of his cancer-stricken son, Beau, in 2015. In his revealing memoir, Promise Me, Dad, A Year of Hope, Hardship, and Purpose, the former vice president recalls singing to his son as he lay in a Washington, D.C. hospital bed. By early May 2015, Beau Biden's health was deteriorating.He was bedridden at Walter Reed Medical Center in Washington, D.C. The complications from his treatments for an aggressive form of brain cancer were taking their toll. The treatments and the virus had robbed Beau Biden of his energy and his appetite. Doctors were forced to insert a feeding tube because he could not eat. He was also breathing with the help of an oxygen tube that fed through his mouth. Beau Biden's entire right side of his body was almost paralyzed. He was also suffering from fluid buildup in his brain that required draining, a procedure that led to more pain whenever he was conscious. He was also stricken with pneumonia, making breathing even more difficult. Doctors needed to pump him with powerful antibiotics to treat it. Jill and I kept reminding each other the doctors had warned us that Beau would get much worse before he got better, Joe Biden writes in his memoir. We kept telling ourselves that these hard times were to be expected and he would turn the corner. Could be any day now. On May 6, Joe Biden walks into his son's hospital room. Honey, guess who was at the office today? The vice president tells his son, who is not responsive. Beau's eyes were closed, but I could tell he could hear me, Joe Biden writes. Elton John was there, he tells Beau. You remember when I used to drive you and his brother Hunter to school? That song we would all sing together, the three of us, as loud as we could. I started singing the lyrics to Beau, quietly, so just the two of us could hear it. The words came back like it was yesterday, but after the first few lines I started to get emotional and wasn't sure if I could go on. Beau didn't open his eyes, but I could see through my own tears that he was smiling. So I gathered myself and kept at it for as much of the song as I could remember. Joe Biden also describes the family's painful goodbye to Beau on May 30, 2015, almost 2 years since doctors first found a lesion on his brain that made him dizzy and gave him auditory hallucinations. Just after 7 p.m., Beau's labored breathing was becoming noticeably quieter. Eventually, he stopped breathing altogether. His brother, Hunter, had briefly left the hospital to get good for the family. He then rushed back to his brother's bedside. Hunt walked over, bent down to kiss him, and placed his hand over his brother's heart, Biden writes. At that moment, the monitor indicated that Beau's heart beat again once more. His diary entry from that night read, May 30, 7:51 p.m. It happened. My God. My boy. My beautiful boy. The former vice president's memoir does not delve into the family drama that was unfolding just a few weeks after his son's death. His bereaved family was being torn apart by his surviving son Hunter's bitter split from his wife amid accusations of blowing a fortune on drugs and sex with prostitutes. Hunter then started a new relationship with his brother Beau's widow. Joe Biden also writes that he believes he would have won the presidency and defeated Hillary Clinton for the Democratic nomination if he chose to run. But the then vice president decided not to run, fearing a stop at nothing campaign by her backers. Biden reveals how he wrestled with the idea of running for office before and after his son Beau's death, and even admits he did not want to be Barack Obama's vice president in 2008. The book documents Biden's life as President Obama's tenure drew to a close, and the media's focus had shifted to the prospects of the presidency. What Biden doesn't mention in his book. A sad story of sex, drugs, and grief. Joe Biden's book makes no mention of the drama that plagued his fractured family after Beau's death. Court documents revealed Hunter Biden's marriage to Kathleen disintegrated shortly after Beau died at exactly the time a newly bereaved vice president was trying to decide whether he should run. She later revealed that she kicked him out on July 5, 2015 because of his conduct the night before. His brother had been dead a little more than a month. In August 2015, When Joe Biden was rising to the top of the polls, Robert Hunter Biden's name was found among the hacked records of users on the extramarital affairs site Ashley Madison. Hunter denied having an account on the site. But DailyMail.com established that the credit card used for the Ashley Madison account was registered to one of Biden's Washington, D.C. addresses. He then claimed the card had been stolen. DailyMail.com was unable to obtain a matching police report. 2 months after the Ashley Madison link emerged, the couple formally separated, which would have also been right around the same time that Joe Biden announced he would not seek office. The news of their split was never made public until this year, when it was revealed Hunter Biden was dating his brother's grieving widow. Kathleen Biden's allegations that he was living a seedy double life were detailed in court documents lodged in February 2017. The couple had overwhelming debt, she told the court, had bounced checks, owed $313.90 in taxes, and he had cut child and spousal support from $17,000 to $7,500 a month the previous October.